Oh. About this very wonderful song, Gaurangera Dutipada by Srila Narottam Das Thakur. Srila Narottam Das Thakur has glorified Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very wonderfully. He says that anyone who has as his only possessions the two lotus feet of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he has attained bhakti. He becomes eligible for pure bhakti. That is bhakti ras. That is braja bhakti. That is, since Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to give what no other incarnation or acharya gave for a very long time, since the previous day of Brahma, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared at that time to give it, Gopi Prem, anyone who has as his only possession the two lotus feet of Gauranga, he's understood to have entered into bhakti ras. He can taste the mellows of Braj Prem. And anyone who's chanting the holy name of Gauranga sincerely, with tears in his eyes, it's understood that he's developed the highest love of Godhead. And Narottam Das Thakur says about such a person who, with tears in his eyes, is chanting the holy names, Jai Boli Hari. Excellent, bravo, congratulations, sadhu sadhu.
Jai Mui Boli Hari.
Jai Mui Boli Hari.
Boli Hari. What is the meaning of Boli Hari?
Congratulations, sadhu sadhu, excellent.
I'm giving my heart and soul to that devotee.
I'm giving my whole heart to that devotee. Narottam Das Thakur himself has prayed that when will tears flow from my eyes by chanting the name of Gauranga. So therefore he says, I'm giving my whole heart to that devotee who is chanting in such a way. And anyone who appreciates the qualities of Gauranga, again, with tears in his eyes, with heart, not just by his ears hearing, but with his heart, such a person can actually enter into Braj and develop love of God. Then he says, anyone who understands that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's associates are all Nitya Siddha Parikar of Krishna. That is, in their Siddha Deha, they have two features. One is with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and one is with Radha Krishna. Just as Srila Raghunath Das Goswami ordered his mind, Sachi Sunam Nandisvara Pati Sutatve, O mind, you should think of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as directly the son of Nanda Maharaj Krishna. Similarly, all of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's eternally liberated associates are also associates of Radha and Krishna. And anyone who understands this, in truth, that means with realization, he also becomes a resident of Vrindavan himself. He also enters into that Chintamani Dham. The very first day that I met Srila Gurudev in 1992, I told him that I'm preaching around the world and I have so much intellectual understanding of the philosophy, but I have no emotions or realizations. So what should I do? So I thought that Srila Gurudev would say, intellectual understanding is not everything. But instead, he said, intellectual understanding is nothing. Only realization is real understanding. So anyone who understands with realization, or in tatvataha, in truth, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's associates are Nitya Siddha Parikars of Radha and Krishna, he also becomes an associate of Radha Krishna. Also, anyone who knows that the Dham of Gauranga is Chintamani and non-different from Vrindavan, that person is also becomes a resident of Vrindavan. Srila Narottam Das Thakur says that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prem, Gaura prem, is an ocean of ras. How is that? Because Krishna himself, although he is Purnanandamoy, the embodiment of all bliss and happiness and the reservoir of all ras, still he's feeling a lack in himself in three ways. What is the nature of Srimati Radhika's love, which, although a drop of my happiness can drown the universe, her love drives me mad? What is it about me? What is it about my qualities that she alone relishes, that even I cannot taste fully? And what is the nature of her happiness that is 10,000 times greater than my own happiness in our loving exchange? Krishna himself could not enter into that Madanakya Mahabhav of Srimati Radhika, though God himself. So in order to enter into that, he covered himself with her complexion and moods. He borrowed them from her and became Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes are Radha and Krishna's pastimes seen from the point of view of Srimati Radhika. Krishna himself learned from Radhika as Gadadhar Pandit, Lalita in the form of Swarup Damodar, and Vishakha in the form of Rai Ramananda. So Gauranga Prem is full of transcendental ras. So Narottam Das Thakur concludes that whether one is a householder or a renunciate, whether he's living in a palace or a forest, anyone who sincerely surrenders to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I myself beg for that person's Sangha, association.
Can you repeat what she told? You. That's to you. Yeah. Stand up and tell what she told. All louder, you should speak.
That person who takes Gauranga's name is a great person. And
what you are looking for. একটাও কথা তো বলবে
গৌরাঙ্গের দুটি পদের যে চার ধর্ম সম্পদ
what you heard you should tell don't see book or anything what she told
wasn't really listening attentively huh? I didn't listen attentively
why what you are doing what you are thinking
nothing actually I was trying to
oh listen but you are thinking that how can I collect something so you have not come for class if you have come why not oh listening very carefully then I will have to punish you do you remember all the prajalp that you were doing in so many days huh? but not hari katha who is most beautiful can you think so I don't want all this that whole day prajalpa and in the class minds you have kept mind other way and you are sitting but your father knows that I have sent because you think that I have come in association this is not called association sit down oh you should tell something jeev I will ask anyone, lady devotee or male devotee, who are sitting on last bench or here.
Shri Shamarani Didi was explaining this kirtan by Narottam Das Thakur, Gaurangera Dutipada Jaradan Dhana Sampada. She was saying, Narottam Das Thakur was saying, whoever has Gauranga Mahaprabhu's, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's, both feet as their only wealth in their life, they are qualified to perform. They are qualified to perform bhakti.
They know it. Especially what is bhakti rash.
They know what is the essence
what
of bhakti.
What is bhakti? Otherwise. She jane bhakti rasa sar. What? Essence of pure bhakti they know. Otherwise, other anyone can.
Then she was saying, Gauranga era madhur lila jarakarna pravashila. Whoever has heard the beautiful lila, past sense of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Jarakana Pravashila. That person's heart is very pure. It's Nirmala. And then Narottam Das Thakur is saying, Je Gauranga Namaloya, Tarahoya Premadoya, Taramui Jai Bolihari. Saying, whoever chants the name of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I give myself completely to them. Bolihari.
So, I will ask you. You too. Oh, I think it is not good to be here and do any prajalpa. We try to avoid mundane talking. Don't do. And don't let your mind here and there. Oh, keep your mind here. And listen and practice. If you are listening, all tattva will come in your heart. And renounce also will come. only desire will go. And if this is not coming, then you should see that, oh, in vain everything, no association at all. You. There are so many proofs, shlokas, glorifying name. Name is, Krishna name is indifferent to Krishna, abhinna, very powerful. Not less than Krishna in any way. So you can quote some and stand up and quote without seeing any paper. Very patiently, carefully you should hear.
Chaksudanamilitam jena tasmai shri gurave namaha. The verse that comes to mind is Nama Chintamani Krishna's Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha Purna Shuddho Nichamukto Abhinatvan Nami Namino. Here, the glories of the holy name are given in summary, and they can be expanded upon indefinitely, unlimitedly from this point. Nama Chintamani Krishna's Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. This holy name is like Chintamani. It will fulfill all your desires. There are three types of name that can be chanted. Nam aparad, that is one where one knowingly commits offenses. Nam abbas, where one is chanting either a shadow or a reflection of the name, chaya or pratibimba. We don't want to chant pratibimba because this is chanted by the Mayavadis and others who have no connection to bhakti. Just like if there's a tree on the bank of the river and the reflection's on the water, but it doesn't actually connect to the tree because the land is separating from the reflection. So this kind of chanting of the name or practice of bhakti, pratibimba, has no actual connection to real bhakti, and we want nothing to do with that. This is in the association of Mayavadis who think that they're chanting the name, but actually they're aparadis. Then chaya means a shadow. So the shadow means, although it is not the name itself, it is a shadow, meaning it has some connection to the real practice of bhakti, because those devotees who are chanting it are in association of sadhus.
So I want that you should explain the meaning of one sloka. Don't explain.
Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. And the name is the form of all rasa. There are five rasas in relationship to Krishna, direct rasas, and seven indirect. And it is the complete whole of all rasas. Purno, it is full there, and complete. Shuddho, it is completely pure, the real name. And Nichamukto is eternally liberated. Someone may ask, how is it that the holy name, being entirely transcendental, can be heard by, in this material world, Krishna? These syllables are heard by our mundane ears and our mundane tongue. The answer is given by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Jiva Dharma, that actually the holy name is a transcendental entity, non-different from Krishna himself, Bhagavat Swarup, in the spiritual world. When actually can only be chanted by the pure spiritual tongue of the jiva when he's in his pure spiritual state. As he approaches that state, that name, attracted by his bhakti, may come and dance on his tongue, appearing in his mind and dancing on his tongue. Those syllables that emanate from that tongue, which is being caused to dance by the name himself, that is Shuddhanam. So,
this is another example.
Another example. Another shloka. Atak Shri Krishna Namadi Nabhavet Grayam Indriyai. Sevan Mukehi Jivadao Svayam Evam Spratjado.
You have explained more.
Nam namakari bahudani jasarva shaktis tatar pitaniya mate smaranena kalaha etadishi tavakripa bhagavan mamapi durdaivam idrisha mahajani nanuragaha. This verse is given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, that, my dear Lord, you have hundreds and thousands of names. These names are in two categories, mukhya and gona, primary and secondary. The Gona names, meaning they have some connection to the gunas, or the modes of nature, in the sense that they describe the Lord in his relationship to this material creation. They're not present in the spiritual abodes. Those names which are both present in the spiritual abodes of the Lord and in this material world are called mukhyanam, or primary names. The secondary names are chanted by those interested in the fruits of karma and gyan, and they don't easily render chitfal, or the fruit of transcendental knowledge or transcendental love. But mukhyanam gives love of Krishna, because these names are directly related to Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha, the Supreme Personality of Godhead in all his beautiful features as the son of Jasoda, the lover of the gopis, and the friend of the cowherd boys. So these names awaken in Krishna Prem directly, whereas the secondary names do not. So Lord Chaitanya, although he's saying you have many thousands of names, he's actually indicating that once you chant the Mukhyanam, the primary names of the Lord, to achieve the benefit of Krishna Prem.
What is Durdaiva there?
Durdaiva means...
And what is the mercy of Krishna that he has manifested himself in name?
The mystery is that the name is more merciful than Krishna himself.
What is written in a sloka you should only explain. And automatically it will come off.
Durdaiva Midrasham Hajani Nanaragaha? That verse?
Nam nam akari bahudha
sarva shaktis. All sarva shaktis. All you have invested all of your potencies in these names. So Krishna is completely present, and in fact he's even more merciful because we have access. Tathagata niyamate smarane na kalaha. Oh, and another mercy of the holy name is there are no considerations in terms of time and place and circumstance. One can chant at all times and in all places and all ways. Once one young small boy saw Chaitanya Mahaprabhu trying to hold on to his tongue while going to the bastul. And this little boy asked, "Oh, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, why are you trying to hold your tongue?" He said, "Because the name is always chanting on my tongue, and I'm afraid it will be not proper to chant while I'm going to the bathroom." So then the little boy said, "Oh, but the holy name is pure and can be chanted at all times and all places. There's no consideration of pure or impure when it comes to chanting the holy name." And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very pleased. He said, "Oh, you are like my guru." So this...
No, like...
You are my guru.
No, never.
No.
This is bad idea.
Gopal guru?
Oh, you are Jagat guru.
From today you are
not of mine.
Oh, Jagat guru.
You should proper here. What is Durdaiva Midrasham?
Because of offenses, it is very difficult for us to chant the holy name. We have no attraction and no taste, and we don't chant constantly like we should. Because the only way to get free from namaparad is to constantly chant. The name is more merciful. If you commit offenses to Krishna's sarup, he cannot forgive that. But if you commit offenses to the name, he'll not only forgive offenses to himself, but also your offenses to Krishna's sarup.
Thank you. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told, Krishna has invested his all power. What power? In a second he can create millions of universe in a moment. Or in a moment he can destroy. And again in a moment he can create. He's very merciful. Very sweet, handsome, ocean of mercy. So he has invested all in these names. Also, Nam Kariya Vibhag, in Chaitanya Charitamrita it has been written. What? Meaning that according to the power and mercy and beauty has been invested in name, in degree, the names are in that degree higher and superior and lower. Like Jagadish, Jagannath, Brahma, Paramatma, Tata, Pata, all these names are gone. Second. Now prominent names also are divided in so many, like Narayan, Nishingha, Vaman, Ram, Krishna. They are all names of Supreme Lord directly, but they have so many categories. All the names have not so one power in them. In these prominent names, mostly we can divide into two. Mukhanam, Gaunam. Narayan here, Supreme Lord here. And he has all appliances. In a moment he can destroy and very merciful too. But not so sweet as Krishna. No rush like Krishna. In Krishna name also there are so many degrees. So many. Gokulnath, Brajanath, Radhanath, Gopinath, Rash Bihari, Radha Kanta, so many. Radha Raman, Radha, so many. So they are connected with the sweet pastimes of their names. So in the last, He Krishna, Karuna Sindho, Dina Bandho, Jagat Pate, Gopesha, Gopika Kanta, Radha Kanta. So very powerful. He has invested all these things. Oh, he has not kept any time or place or anything, circumstance, no rule, regulation to chant in day, in night, without taking bath, after taking bath. Even a most wretched person like Ajamil, he can chant. Even a devotee like Narad, he can chant. Without mala or with mala, only singing, not anyhow, in mind, in tongue, in heart, any kind. He can do. But, oh, I'm very unfortunate. I have no taste in these names. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling, not for him, for us all. We have no strong faith that Krishnam Ichintamani, Rasa Vigraha, he can fulfill our all desires. Even we have no faith that Krishna can give me money, this name. So this is our Durdaiva. Why? Durdaiva is aparad. We have done so many offenses. So be with high class of devotees, follow them, serve them. And thus, your all offenses will go, past, future, and present, and then your heart will be pure, then you can realize. More examples of Shastra.
Kale kale nama rupe Krishna avatar nama hoite hai sarva jagat nishtar. This name of Krishna has descended and is actually incarnation in this age of Kali. Krishna manifests in this material world in two forms, Adui Rup. This verse I forget. There's two forms of Antaryami.
Don't the Lord, help anyone. You should do.
The Lord within the heart is one roop of Krishna, and the other is in the Nam. He manifests in this name. non-different. As Bhakti Sarmaraj has explained and Gurudev further gave deep explanations of the name, non-different from the Lord. By chanting this holy name, all the world can be delivered. Savar Jagat Nishtar. The holy name can deliver the entire universe when it is taken up seriously. And gradually,
if any other shlok?
I had one sitting there. I stand up.
Don't see the book. No. Oh, you have seen whole life.
Syat Krishna Nama Charitari Siktaptya Vidya. Pitok Pitapta Rasanasya Norochikanu. Kintara Arunan Kalasarva Justa. Sadvik Kramad Bhavati. So this verse
is not.
Upadeshamrita.
This is not. Another. Glorify. This is the quality. How we can develop. But no glorification here. Please sit down. Please sit down. Or stand up only from there, you should. No need of. No need.
Hare Nama, Hare Nama. Hare Nama eva kevalam kalona steva nasteva gatir anyataha.
You forget? What is meaning?
The meaning of this is that in this age of Kali, there is no other process, no better process, no more easier process than the chanting of the holy names.
Not easier only. Oh, very.
But emphasis in only.
But only one this Harinami is. Harinami is. Harinami is.
Only me. The only process is the chanting of the holy names in the age of Kali. No by yoga, not by developing any kind of knowledge, or mystic powers, one can attain the ultimate goal of life, which is the pure love and affection for Shri Radha and Krishna in Braja. Only by this powerful process of chanting the holy names under the guidance of pure Rasika Vaishnavas in the line of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, very easily we can attain the shelter of the holy name. And as we heard from Srimati Shamarani Didi in explaining this song in the beginning of the class, we can attain that very special treasure which Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to distribute.
More. There are thousands and thousands of glorification of men. Oh, don't speak anymore. Otherwise, I'll make them stand.
Kaler doshe nide rajam nasti eka.
What Jeev pound is copying by book? Go.
Kaler dose nijay rajam nasti eka mahaguna kirtanat eva krishnasya mukta sangam param prajat. In this age of Kali, there is only one process, and that is the congregational chanting, sankirtan, of the holy names. Again, this means being in the association of pure Vaishnavas chanting the holy name. Then Cheto Darpana Mahajanam Mahabhakti Nirvapanam.
What? Utter this shlok again with very carefully. That some meaning should come.
This age of Kali is full of...
No. That is shlok I want to hear.
Kaler Doshe Nidhi. Cheto Darpana Mahajanam. Bhava Mahadavakti Nirvapanam, Shreya Kairava Chandrika Vitaranam, Vidya Bhadu Jivanam, Anandam Buddhi Vardaram, Pratipadam Purnam Ritasvaranam, Sarvatma Snap Param Vidayate, Sri Krishna Sankirtanam.
What is the meaning?
The meaning is, whatever I've heard, I will try to repeat that. This holy name, chanted in that association of pure Vaishnavas, it will very quickly cleanse.
Answer, after initiation and having relation with Krishna in the guidance of
pure Vaishnava
devotee. Then
that chanting of the holy name with some Vanda Gyan, with having proper initiation, with attentively practicing the process of sadhu sangha, meaning when we hear something, it enters the heart, not one ear in, one ear out. Yeah. Only when it stays within the heart, that is proper sadhu sangha. When we chant the holy names in this way, then it will cleanse the heart. First symptom will be that we will see who we really are. Jivirus Swarupahai Krishna Nityadas. We will realize that we are actually eternal servant of Krishna. After that, very easily, we will realize that there is no any difficulty in our lives. Although this material world is described as a blazing fire, full of so many anxieties, especially problems. Everybody is in anxiety. Where is happiness? Where is pure love? Yeah. Where is my wealth? Where is that thing which will satisfy me, which will give me that happiness which I'm looking for? Nowhere, not in anything in this world we can find it. Only when we take shelter under this process, yeah, which is being presented by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, properly chanting, under the guidance, having proper initiation, understanding what is my relationship with Krishna, with this material world, how this material world is like a prison. And if I don't take shelter of that opportunity, that's very special mercy which is offered by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his pure devotees. They are inviting us, come, come, come. And we say, no, no, no. Yeah. Even we are in sadhu sangha, we think we are in sadhu sangha, but it is very rare. Then Shaya Kairava Chandrika Vitaranam. Then after that, yeah, what will happen within our heart? Yeah, the sprout of Krishna Prem, or the sprout of love of God, it will blossom, and it will become by that very special, like a moonlight, yeah, the beams of mercy which are entering the heart, the lotus which is manifested, blossoming within the heart, is the lotus of love for Krishna.
No. All favorable qualities will come in him. All favorable quality, humbleness, tina tapi suni, taru rupi, sarishnuna, all by which you can progress. And then?
Then Vidya Vada Jivanam. Name is the wealth, yeah, the Vidya Vadu, the ultimate or the highest essence of all knowledge.
Vidya is Vadu. And most beloved of
Krishna.
Name. Name means Krishna. Name.
Yes.
Is who? Most beloved?
Of Srimati Radhika.
And her mood to serve Krishna. Vidya Vadu, Jivan, this name.
So this name is?
That is the life and soul and most beloved of bhakti. Means, ye naam Krishna bhakti ka jivan swarup hai. Bhakti kaha hai? Radha ji ke hriday mein hai. Uska jivan kaun hai? Jivan hai ye naam. Most beloved. By naam, these kinds of bhakti, very high class of bhakti may come. You should explain this, what I want to tell. Only this is
love. Here Srila Gurudev is explaining, Vidya Vadhu Jivanam. This Sankirtanam, Krishna Nam, is Jivanam, the life and soul of Vidya Vadhu. The word Vidya means knowledge. But what is the greatest knowledge? In fact, the only knowledge. The only knowledge is how to please Krishna. So who knows how to please Krishna? Who is the embodiment of loving services to Krishna? Oh, she is Vadhu. Vadhu means young bride. Srimati Radhika is a young bride in Braj. She's Vadhu. And she's the embodiment of all the knowledge. That means devotion, how to satisfy Krishna. So when the devotee comes into this stage, Vidya Vadhu Jivanam, this is the stage of Asakti. And in that stage, he can realize something, how it is that the name of Krishna is the life and soul of Srimati Radhika, in whose heart there is the endless origin of all types of devotion.
Then after that, Vidya Buddhi Jivanam, Ananda Buddhi Vardhan. Go on. Finish this sloka.
Anandam.
Anandam Buddhi Vardhanam. So this name is the endless ocean of transcendental happiness. Yeah, after we...
What? Vardhanam? Meaning Vardhanam? Anandam Buddhi Vardhanam. This name brings so many like tides, waves of ananda, like moon. By moon, in ocean so many waves coming. Ananda Ambudhi Vardhanam. So, name, from name, ocean of ananda is increasing.
Then, so it increases the ocean of transcendental happiness,
yes.
This name. Pradipadam Purnam Ritasvadanam. It, at every step, the Purnam Rita, the complete nectar is experienced.
Purnam Ritasvadanam.
Asvadanam.
Sarvatmasnapanam.
Saratmasnam Param. Vidyaita is Sri Krishna Sankirtan. It completely satisfies and cools the self, this chanting, pure chanting.
When a devotee can sing in the ocean of nectar, of bhakti, prem, love, and he cannot come out of this. Sarvat Nashnapana. Fully drowned in ocean of love. Thank you. You stand up. More. Very soon, very soon. From there, your voice is more than.
Not a piece of it, okay?
I don't know. Any glorification really should be. This is the process how name can be taken, not glorification.
So, Om Gyanati Mirandasya Gananjana Shalakaya Chakshu Unritam Jaina Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, there's discussion on the glorification of the holy name. And there...
No. I want only slokas, not story.
Then there's one sloka, Sanketyam Parihasyam. Sanketyam Parihasyam Stobanam Helanam Va. There, it's explained that the holy name is so powerful that even if one is not chanting pure name, Shuddhanam, but one is only chanting Namabhas, a shadow of the holy name, in four ways. Sanketyam means that one may be referring to somebody else and chanting the name, just as one may have a son, and the son's name may be Narayan. And calling out the son, O Narayan. He's not calling Lord Narayan. He's calling his son who has that name Narayan. But still, that name, it has such potency. Sanketyam, Parihasyam. That one may be calling in a joking way. Just like, or in a theatrical performance. Somebody may be in a play and he's chanting, O Govinda, O Gopal, O Govinda, O Gopal. Or Sanketyam, Parihasyam, Stobanam, derisively. Saying, oh, you Hare Krishnas, why don't you get a job? You're just going out chanting on the streets, you're menaces to society. Do something. You chant Krishna, Krishna, you're rubbish. So they're chanting and they're derisively calling the name. Or Helinamva, one who neglectfully is calling out the names. But these names are so powerful that if one chants such name, either unintentionally in a theatrical performance, neglectfully or derisively, That power of that shadow of the name, it will remove all sins that one has committed in the past, committing in the present, and that one will commit in the future. That the name has such power. In Srimad Bhagavatam, also stated, Kechit Kevalaya Bhaktyam Vasudeva Parayana. That Kechit Kevalaya Bhaktyam.
Vasudeva Parayana, not name.
So,
if anywhere you are going to glorifying name, you should know all these things. So I, and you should be very bold and strong in name.